You need to wipe down.
What's with the jeans?
Hey, Hitler.
Hey, Hitler.
Hey, Hitler.
Hey, Hitler. Hey, Hitler.
Hey, Hitler.
Hey, Hitler.
Hi, Mommy. Hi, Mommy. Hi, Mommy. Hi, Mommy. Hi, Mommy. Hi, Mommy. Hi, Mommy.
DJ. Dadmouth, you had the shit last week. DJ, Dadmouth.
That's really a cool story.
DJ, Dadmouth.
Ladies and gentlemen, two completely different buttholes.
Yeah. DJ.
And to me, it's no competition.
DJ.
Here we go.
Thanks, Hitler.
Is there any Hitler porn out there?
My fjord.
You know I don't know, my baby.
My fjord. Give me my fjord.
My fjord. That's what's up with Robin Wright's ass.
Do you think her butthole really tastes different? Different?
I think it has to. I think it has to.
Hi, mommy.
Whoa.
Wow.
I think I'm muted. You think you're muted?
Meow. I can't hear myself. Oh, here we go. Okay.
Yeah, I think you're...
Meow.
You should be okay, right?
Yeah, it's good. Yeah.
That was Topheroy? I don't know. And then here's Sean DL with this. Thank you for sending in your music, your instrumentals, and your songs that you make for the show. They're super entertaining and fun. We got a lot going on. I'm in Fartniks this weekend at the Stand Up Live. I'm excited. Four shows. The great Josh Potter from... Buffalo is coming with me.
Barfalo.
So, should be great. Four shows. They are really moving quickly. The tickets, it's amazing. It's a big room. But thank you guys for your support there. And that's just the 26th, 27th. March 10th through 12th, Tacoma.
To come on you.
In Washington.
Washington is so annoying.
At the to come on your comedy club. So, please come there. March 17 through 19, the Punchline in Sacramento, California. Big Ernie's coming with me.
Oh, Big Ern. Yeah. Ernie, what's her real name?
Andy Erickson.
Yeah, she was on Last Comic Standing. Yeah. Very funny.
She's coming with me. Hilarities in Cleveland, Ohio. Cleveland Steamer, Ohio. Full Charge is coming with
you. Oh, yay. You're going to have fun with him.
31st to the 2nd. And then Spooky Can.
Sperm Can.
Sperm Can Comedy Club and Sperm Can Washington. That'll also be in April. I have a bunch of other dates coming. A lot of places coming that are on the books already, of which I can think of none. And as soon as the tickets are on sale, I'll mention them. Jeans, anything else?
Oh, for me? Okay. The 9th of March, Marilyn Rice Cub, Joe Rogan, Greg Fitzsimmons.
What?
Yeah, we're doing a fundraiser for Marilyn's kids' school, apparently. And it should be really fun. It's the Comedy Store on March 9th. Please come out and help us raise funds for these stupid kids that are stupid and they need money, I guess.
Jeez.
For books and things.
Okay.
If they even have books anymore at school.
Okay.
These poor white kids.
Cool.
Okay. And then April 1st and 2nd at Flappers
mm-hmm.
in Sperm Bank, California.
Mm-hmm.
420, the Fuhrer's birthday.
What?
Ventura Comedy Club. Get your tickets now. The link should be up. And then the 27th of May and the 28th, I'm at the La Jolla Comedy Store in La Jolla, California. That's fancy San Diego.
Great.
Hey.
Old lady, I just like what you're saying. Since you ain't got no extra hush puppies to sell.
What's that? I like it. Is that a new character you're working on for your act?
No.
Guys, if you shop on Amazon, would you please use our banner? All you have to do is go to yourmomshousepodcast.com, click on the banner at the bottom of the homepage, and just do your shopping as you normally would, and it kicks back some change.
Yeah.
Oh, have you guys seen our Instagram?
Yeah.
It's very exciting. Tom and I have been putting up little teasers for these episodes on our Instagrams.
It's fun.
I'm Christina Paz, and you are...
Segura Tom.
Because some a-hole took Tom Segura.
Well, he's a kid. He's British.
Fuck that guy.
He's 18 now.
How do you know all this about him?
Because I follow him and I talk to him. I post comments on his page.
Did you call him a shithead for stealing your
name? I just said, like, what are we doing this week? let's be the Tom Segura's to get things done.
Does he look like you?
No, he's very thin. Hmm. He's a good looking kid.
He doesn't have those pretty blue eyes.
He loves his girlfriend. That's all he posts.
Aww.
He's just like, I love her.
Why don't you post things like that about me?
So how annoying would it be? Is there anything more annoying than when there's a couple and somebody just posts?
Yes.
It's so fucking terrible.
Or I also don't believe the proclamations of how much they love each other. Like, I'm just the luckiest woman in the world. My husband's the best. Like, okay, what's going on?
Yeah, we both know people like that. it's so gross when they do that.
I think it's phony.
Yeah.
The bullshit.
All right, you ready to do this?
Yeah.
Let's do this.
FedEx. You said that wrong in the copy.
I did?
It's not FedEx. It's FedEx.
Why is this not playing?
Uh-oh. Fuck your mom. What's wrong?
It's not playing.
The audio is not coming through at all?
Just didn't play.
Is it on mute? I've done that before.
Mm-mm. Try it again.
Are you a big believer in no sex before fighting?
Yeah, man, I still believe that, man, because, I mean, I do my thing, but you know what I'm saying? I don't, you know, you got a whole, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm talking about, man.
I have a vague idea what you're talking about.
This shit is big time!
Who is Randy?
Don't bring anyone loving to this.
Your mom in the fucking stand!
Welcome to your mom's house. With Tom Segura. Tom Segura. And
Christina Pajitza.
Welcome to your mom's house.
That guy.
That was Kimbo Slice.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? Who, you know what I'm saying? Fought Dada 5000, you know what I'm saying, this weekend.
You know?
And it was a really underwhelming fight. Joe watched the fight. It wasn't a UFC fight, but he watched it. And tweeted out, this may be the worst fight I've ever seen.
Really?
Mm-hmm. It's basically two. It shows you the difference between pros and amateurs.
Mm-hmm.
These guys are two street fighters.
Mm-hmm.
Both of them got internet fame. Dada's more from actually Billy Corbin, who you know directed Cocaine Cowboys and you know those about Griselda Blanco.
I love her.
So his he made a documentary, I think Dogfight is what it's called, which Dada 5000 is one of the stars of, which it basically highlights backyard brawls in Miami, right?
Nice.
And so that's what this guy got a reputation for, or got a reputation from.
Oh, he's from Miami?
He's from Miami, and so is Kimbo. Kimbo's from Miami. Kimbo was a kind of a notorious backyard brawler before these documentaries, or before Billy's documentary, and he got famous basically because he also looks like just a terrifying dude, you know, just big beard, huge build, and there's video of him just fucking people up in backyards. But when you take guys like that you know, a street fighter, let's call it, and you try to put him in a professional setting,
it's different
stories. It's a different story, yeah.
Different strokes, huh?
Same strokes. Same folks. So what happened was
Everybody's the same. The
guys had, like, no conditioning. I mean, they were just both out of breath, and it looked like, I think they said in the, I saw a story or a report later that said Dada had his heart stopped.
What?
The hospital. Yeah, he's okay now, but basically neither guy was conditioned for professional fighting.
Oh.
I mean, that's one, you know, that's definitely what it sounds like. I don't know if there's any other expert opinions that want to weigh in.
But, oh, I know what we're gonna talk about.
Oh yeah, I have that all queued up. Okay, just checking.
So he's talking about busting nuts.
Yeah, so that's like a red carpet interview before some press thing going on.
He's only got but two nuts to bust.
I ain't got but two nuts to bust. So
that's a shout out to Jimmy.
Yes, that's one of my favorite stories ever.
Shit, bitch.
I said, bitch, I ain't got two nuts to bust. That did not. No one's asking you that. Yeah, man. So, so anyways, they ask him before it all goes down. They said, hey, man, do you believe in abstaining from sex before fights like a lot of athletes do?
Are you a big believer in no sex before fighting?
Yeah, man, I still believe that, man, because, I mean, I do my thing, but you know what I'm saying? I don't, you know, you got a whole, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm talking about, man.
I have a vague idea what you're talking about.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? No, the hell we don't. You ain't saying anything yet.
I don't know what you're saying. Is that the judge?
I don't know what you mean. No, that's a different guy.
Right now, I don't know what you're saying. I don't know what you mean.
You know what I'm saying?
I love, you know what I'm saying, supercuts.
It's so good.
Yeah. Tripped me out because, you know what I'm saying, pimps was getting at them hoes. You know what I'm saying? You know, stomping down on them hoes. And I'm like, well, hold on, man. I don't understand this part of the game, man. This shit's supposed to be about choice. You know? So my mentor, you know what I'm saying, he set me back and he said, hold on, pimping, man. Let me tell you something, man. You know,
what?
When you cross the country pimping, man, you know what I'm saying? You know, you pimping at a hoe, you know what I'm saying, 24/7. You know what I'm saying? You know, you shuffling up the crowd. You know what I'm saying? You know, you trying to find out exactly what's happening on that track. Okay, cool. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna sit back and I'm gonna open up the track. You know what I'm saying? And you know, I told the hoes, you know what I'm saying, make your way into figure eight, bitch. You dig what I'm saying?
When I talked about how you sitting there and the first words out of your mouth is, you know what I'm saying, you know what I mean? No, the hell we don't. You ain't say anything yet.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, shit.
That's so good.
It's so,
you know,
good.
But I think this fighter is
now.
Yeah, that's the best one.
You know what I'm saying? I ain't never had a job before in my life until I started working for Sil. You know, in and out of jail. You know what I'm saying? Did a little bit of everything. You know what I'm saying? Now I'm. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I know what you're saying.
That's the best one because he literally says nothing.
You know, I mean, it didn't get away. You know what I'm saying? They made a play at the end. It was a questionable travel call. You know what I'm saying? It didn't go our way. And they made a decent play. You know what I'm saying? I had a good look. You know, MC had a better look. You know what I'm saying? So it was just, you know I'm saying? They made one more plays than we did, man. It wasn't like the game got out of control. I'm saying they came out with a lot of energy, which we knew they was going to do. I'm saying we fought back. We took the lead. You know what I'm saying? But they ultimately, I'm saying they got the W. And we did.
You had a terrific game offensively. What was the atmosphere out there like with the whole return of Iverson?
You know, it was going to be very emotional, you know what I'm saying? They not want another player to come in here and get more attention or love than they were getting. You know what I'm saying? So they go come out like gangbusters, and they did, you know what I'm saying? But we fought back. We were in position to win the game. We weren't able to get it done.
Interesting playing against Andre Miller and Reggie Evans.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? They still close friends of ours, you know what I'm saying? So it's competitive, but it's still love at the same time.
Thank you.
It's so many.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? 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 You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
That's so many, y'all.
I got a 2001 Chevrolet Suburban, you know what I'm saying? Putting on for the city. It took me about 6 months to put it together. I had it like this like 2 years now, you know what I'm saying?
It's a lot.
You know.
Do you like hip hop, yo?
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? Yo.
You know what I'm saying?
That's all a foreign person hears when they listen to interviews or hip hop. You know what I'm saying?
Shouts out to homeboy Mitch, you know what I'm saying?
Slickster.
Hell yeah, you know what I'm saying? Mutual homie. Good motherfucker right there, you know what I'm saying? So, you know what I'm saying? He's only going to fuck with the real, you know what I'm saying? So.
God.
Right now, I don't know what you're saying. I don't know what you mean.
All right. Oh, so good. I like that Street the Fighter, though. That's my new favorite, you know what I'm saying?
The fighter guy?
Because he goes, you know.
Are you a big believer in no sex before fighting?
Yeah, man, I still believe that, man, because, I mean, I do my thing, but you know what I'm saying? I don't, you know, you got a whole, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm talking about.
I have a vague idea what you're talking about.
And last week, we had Ghostface had so many nah me.
You know what I mean? You know what I mean? It's no, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? 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 You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? You know what I mean? You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? You know what I mean? You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? It's like, yo, man. And then you switching it. You know what I mean? You know.
You said like 100 in that clip. God.
Who do you think has the most, you know what I'm saying? I know we did this one time where we tallied up.
Well, somebody pointed out back then when we played it more, they were saying that you need a real formula for you know what I'm saying. And it's got to be know what I'm saying per second. So you could, like, Ghost said 100 know what I'm saying, but that clip was 15 minutes long.
Sure.
So they said it's about saying know what I'm saying in a concise.
It's relative to the time.
Exactly.
To be scientific. Yeah.
Which is why this Rob guy.
Real recognized, real game, recognized game, you know what I'm saying? Ain't no busters, ain't no fakes over here, you know what I'm saying? It's all real deal, you know what I'm saying? All this shit we talk.
I mean, that's just, you know, one, two, three.
But then there's the other criterion of, do we count the entire phrase, you know what I'm saying? And then there's, you know what I mean? Yeah. Nah, I'm saying.
Yeah.
There's so many variants on
there's
it.
There's variants.
That's the problem with the quantifying it.
I do think you have to throw them in to the throw their hat in the ring, if you will. The nah means and nah, you know.
That's a whole other game. That's a whole other game.
No, I think that they count. I don't think so.
I disagree. I think we got to keep the game pure, you know.
What?
It's got to be pure. It's the phrases are, you know what I'm saying? Nah, I mean. Know what I'm talking about? You feel me? You know?
Uh-huh.
It's a total, they're all different categories.
So wait, all of them are different categories?
I think so.
That's crazy.
I think, you know what I'm saying? My favorite, you know what I'm saying, is still the Suge Knight documentary, though, the one that
I thought you just got won over by Kimbo.
But I'm saying now I think second place is, it's between those two now. Hmm. Who's your favorite? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
I don't know.
I did like the Asian girl too.
Yo, you know what I'm saying? I think this is one of my favorite.
Not many foreign, you know what I'm saying?
This is Saphir.
Yeah, check it out. You know what I'm saying? It's Saphir. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Check this out, though. I'm throwing a motherfucking shout out to my man, Boss Man, you know?
Name shit, Barty Bo, baby.
You know what I'm saying? Straight West Side, 2-4.
Now he's letting it go, you know what I'm saying?
Sure.
Which is the original, you know what I'm saying?
Sure.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
But then, you know what I'm saying? And know what I'm saying? That's the same shit.
You know, it's got to be, you know what I'm saying.
No, come on.
Know what I'm saying is a different phrase than you know what I'm saying.
What are you talking about?
I'm sorry, if we're going to play technical,
the same thing.
We're going to be by the rules.
And nah, I mean, that's a whole other
phrase. Nah, I mean's a whole other category.
You're crazy, man.
And then, you know, you heard.
These are all different to you.
These are all different
shit.
Different
thing.
Games. Different games.
Okay. You know, I just.
I'm a purist.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
What I just saw right here that I haven't seen in a long time.
Cops are all bald and shit.
Oh, yeah.
Fucking bald and shit. Fucking cops are fucking bald.
That guy was drunk in our old neighborhood. That was the really old hood.
Yeah, two hoods ago.
And we lived in the Rampart Division.
It's crazy that we lived in the Rampart Division.
Hey.
Look it up.
Hey.
Google me, Rampart.
Not anymore.
No.
God.
So.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? We'll get back to the dumb sayings in a moment. This is going to be this is the second to last episode in this office.
I know.
Isn't that crazy?
It's been a good.
I don't know if we've said it yet. Have we said it yet on the show?
No.
We haven't said it?
No. We haven't told them.
This is our last episode ever.
We're in a suicide pact.
We're done. I'm just kidding.
Just kidding.
We're moving, though.
Yes.
We're moving the our home and our office.
Yes.
And we're excited and overwhelmed. It's exciting to move. We're moving back to proper Los Angeles. We're kind of south in Los Angeles County by 20 miles. It's a commute. It's been a fun go down here. But
yeah, I really like it, but it's too far. With baby jeans, we can't be going into town and back.
So we're going to be living in the front part neighborhood. And it's going to be good to be back in L.A.
Well, the neat thing is we haven't really settled into this office.
That's the best thing. I looked at one of the comments under our episode we put up.
Yeah.
And somebody wrote, like, what's up with your office? Looks like you guys are on the run from the feds. Like, set it up.
Might be. Yeah, we never properly settled in here for many reasons. It's been also a noise issue.
It's really bad.
We have a Pilates studio beneath us. Next door. You know these dickheads who talk on speakerphone and they think everybody wants to hear what they say?
It was like that before you got here, by the way.
Of course. She's such a POS.
And I talked to the landlord last week.
Yeah.
And he goes, with regard to the Pilates, I'm definitely going to talk to them. And I was like, oh, well, that's cool.
Now?
Yeah, now you're going to talk to them. start the conversation now. It's been about 6 months that I've been talking about this.
Yeah, and they just started the class when I pulled in. The whole fucking parking lot's taken up by Pilates a-holes. And now their music's going to crank up. It's the worst.
Anyways,
the worst.
We're moving.
We're out.
Really excited about it. It'll be a much smaller room, but it'll be our room.
Can I tell you, it's so much better for sound, though, when it's small.
I know.
You know, and it's going to be better.
I know what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying?
I do know
you know what I'm talking
saying.
About? Feel me?
I do know what you're saying.
I'm excited to move. We have hired movers. This is one thing we've learned as adults.
Don't do it yourself.
Do not move your damn self.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I do.
You got to hire a motherfucker to do that shit.
It's the best.
Motherfucker.
Yeah, it's the best.
So it's going to be relatively stress-free, hoping.
Do you remember, not the last move to our current place, but the move before?
From Rampart?
Yes, where the movers had me help.
Yeah. We were so poor, though. We were like, all right. We didn't even have money to move, man.
I know, but we paid them, and then it was the hottest day
on
in
record.
80 years.
Yeah.
They had never had a hotter day.
In October.
And it was 113, and the guys were like, I mean, you don't have to help, but it's going to take a long time. I was like, okay. So I just lifted and carried shit.
And they were drinking beers. It was their break.
Yeah, and the guy goes, I don't get drunk. Like, I can just drink and work. And I was like, all right, man.
Do you remember we gave away, I had a television that my dad gave me in 1989, and you forced me to throw it away. It was a Toshiba. And we left it in front of our old Rampart Division apartment, and we put a bet on how long it would last out there.
It wasn't long.
We took a drive around the block, and it was
gone. Yeah.
Zoinks. I don't think I walked on that street. I think one time I walked around the block.
Yeah.
And that's the only time I walked on the street when we
lived
there.
The bad thing in that neighborhood at the time really was theft, like break-ins.
Yes.
You know,
and homicide.
No, there wasn't a lot of homicides.
I looked on the crime maps.
There wasn't a lot of homicides.
It was enough to...
It was homicide. Look,
yeah.
The fact that there are a homicide is not... A homicide is bad. There were a few homicides. But it wasn't an extremely violent, you know, homicide a week neighborhood.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? It's not...
There was a lot of aggravated assaults.
There were some fights.
A lot of break-ins, like you said.
Yes.
I remember looking at those crime maps.
I remember when we moved from there, the car insurance went way down. And I was like, wait a minute, what? And they said, oh yeah, you moved from the break-in capital of LA to a better, any area is better than where you live.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, okay.
Can I tell you what I liked about that apartment building? Mm. Is that there was a garbage chute.
Yeah.
So that is the best.
If that's
you live
great.
In an apartment where they have just a chute and you can throw anything down there. And we were throwing. Remember, Dilly? We threw really bad shit down there, shit that you weren't supposed to throw, I remember.
Like what? Bacon grease?
Christmas tree. Yeah, bacon grease.
I like throwing heavy like appliances down a chute.
I think
like that.
We did.
Yeah, we did.
Like VCRs we didn't want.
Boom! Like it's just such a loud.
It's the best. Yeah. It's so much fun.
And you hear that?
Yeah.
Just the crack.
Four stories.
And the break. Yeah. Like, ooh. That doesn't work anymore for sure.
No. And when we decided we were going to move on up and out of there,
yeah.
We finally made a little bit of money. I'll never forget, we got out on the patio. We had a patio. and we launched that champagne bottle, remember?
The cork, oh, yeah.
Pop, we just popped it out into the ghetto. And we're like, we're the fuck out of here, man. That was a long year.
You know what I remember the most about that place is that I was on a BET show.
Yes.
I did stand-up once on BET.
I remember that.
And one day, so I one of the guys on the hall, just a nice dude, I would just see him, you know, walking in and out. You'd see him on the elevator. So I show up to this BET shoot, and who's there but the guy who lives on our hall?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, what are you doing here? And he goes, oh, I'm a producer on this. What are you doing here? And I'm like, I'm on the show.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, cool. So it's a guy that I'm friendly with. So, you know, it's kind of cool to run into him at this shoot. So we taped the show. A little while later, I see him on the hall, in the hallway, and I go, hey, man, is there a way I can get a copy of my set on that show? Because that was like a big, that was bigger then to do than now. Now everything kind of lives online, so you don't really have to request things. But back then you did. Anything that you did, you'd try to get a copy of, right?
That's the worst. The endless pursuit of a DVD of something you did. Yeah.
So can I get that? And he goes, I don't know, man. You could call whatever, like the office, and ask for somebody. Maybe they can get it. And I'm like, wait, weren't you a producer on the show? Yeah. You can't help me get a copy? He's like, mm-mm. You can call somebody, though. He gave me the number. He gave me a number that I called, and I told the lady, I was on the show, one mic, you know, and I want to get a copy. Yeah. I'll leave a message for somebody. Like, not for me. I'll leave a message for somebody else. I called a couple times. It was...
Yeah. Not my problem. Not my job.
Yeah.
A lot of that, huh?
It was like I was asking them for, you know, to donate organs.
Right.
And while they're alive. Could you give me your kidney now? And they're like, I don't know, man.
Really, I can't do that. It's too hard.
It's going to hurt a lot, yeah.
Oh, the show that I worked on?
Yeah.
I don't know where that is. Yeah.
You're a producer on. You have no idea how to get me a copy?
And you know how easy it would have been for him?
I don't know, man.
It's him walking down the hallway to an edit bay going, hey, do you have the copy of Tom Segura's stand-up? Yeah, it's right here, this edit bay.
Can you just, like,
can you give me a copy?
Output that real quick?
Right, no. I don't know where
Not
that
me,
is.
Not me, man. That's somebody else.
Not my job.
That was the worst.
I remember one of our neighbors, they had roosters.
Yeah.
Remember next door neighbors?
Yeah.
These motherfuckers had roosters.
Oh, yeah. You called, right?
And I called the animal control on them to have it taken away because that thing would crow at 5 in the morning.
For hours.
Go, 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 go. Or like, who the fuck has a... And they would let them loose and they were in the streets.
Yeah.
A few times I would come home and the fucking roosters
would go across the street. I don't
know if our
listeners can guess the racial makeup of this neighborhood, but... A lot of roosters.
El rooster.
El roosteros. Yeah. That was fucking too much, man. Too much.
You know, we got lucky, though. We never got robbed, beaten, raped.
You know how I got that guy back? I didn't really get him back on purpose, but what really pissed him off? He, like a lot of people in buildings where you have shared laundry units, will sometimes leave their laundry said laundry machine. As long as they feel like it.
Yeah, it's the worst.
So one time, you know, I checked the machine. There's laundry in it. I go back 30 minutes later. It's still there. I go back 30 minutes later. It's still there. So I took it out. And as I was leaving the machine at the laundry room, he walked up.
He was like, he caught you.
Yeah, he's like, did you take this out of there? And I go, I didn't. See, I saw. That was like
what?
That. So I just put the. Because of the other thing. And he goes, man, I can't believe somebody would touch my stuff. And I'm sitting there thinking, like, dude, you left it there for an hour? You think that's
dummy.
Okay? It's a public machine.
Yeah, the whole floor uses it.
Yeah, we all want to do laundry. But I didn't act like I did it.
No,
I was
of course.
Like, nah, man,
that's how you do that.
Yeah.
Can you believe there was only one washer and one dryer for an entire floor of people in that complex, and how disgusting looking back that we shared a washer and dryer with like a floor full of people, just strangers.
I know, and like poor people. It was gross.
Yeah, that's the grossest part.
That's when your clothes really gets dirty. Ugh. When it has like other poor like skin flakes on it, you're like, ugh.
Now that I think about it, it's pretty nasty.
There's no detergent strong enough for that poor stuff to get off of you.
Poor people.
Ugh. Yuck. Yuck, yuck, yuck.
I'm living the whatever the fuck I want life.
Yeah. That's how you know you're an adult, is when you have your own washer and dryer.
Yeah.
When we moved into Silver Lake, I was like, oh, this is it, dude. This is big time. And it cost us, I remember being like, oh, this is really expensive. You know?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I mean? Yeah, I'm talking about, you feel me? You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I know.
So, another move. Here we go. Every 3 years, our assholes itch and we got to move.
Yeah, so this is it, man.
Yeah.
You know, Bri-Bright pointed out to me, that's pretty much my whole life.
As a child? Wow.
Well, I mean, with the exception being the first move, because I was 9 years old.
Yeah.
I moved to the next city, lived there 2 years.
No shit.
Next city, 3 years. Next city, 3.5 years. College, 4 years. You know? Every few years I move.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Huh.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I feel it in my asshole too, though, when it's time to go.
You do feel it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I moved around too, but not different entire cities. Just like in the valley.
Yeah. I don't know. I feel that way with cars too. You know,
bitches.
It itches.
No, bitches.
Oh, bitches. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Bitches for sure. But after a little bit of time, I'm like, I already done nutted in here.
Yeah.
Gotta go. Okay. You know?
I had a dream last night that you cheated on me. I was so angry with you this morning.
I love the dreams like that.
God, I was so upset with you.
Yeah.
You're the worst.
So we played Kimbo, who was saying, you know. And then I just played a little drop there of Conor McGregor. He is a UFC fighter who has won at multiple weight classes, I believe, and he's going to fight again at a different weight class. And it's sort of a dual master of accent segment. You can hear what I'm capable of there.
Okay.
But also, I just love his attitude here because he's being asked, you know, what he wants to do. And he says, I do whatever the fuck I want.
I like that
because
answer.
I generate a lot of money for the company.
That's a good answer.
It's pretty awesome, you know? So
I think that it's a little bit
nice that it's well
overhyped just because the expectations fuck? Were low.
Mm-hmm. Where's that? Where's that coming from?
Oh, Blue Band.
That's weird.
Blue Band. You know what I'm saying?
Sometimes, God damn it.
What happened?
The internet just fucking stopped working.
Can you believe there was a time before the internet?
Yeah.
How the I kind of wish it was back anything? Here. I know. What were we even talking about?
Time. Well, back then we had to talk about farts and then fart on command. And now we can just, you know, press a fart button.
Can I, when you were doing that, I got the most disturbing email. Can I read it to you?
Oh, yeah, please.
I'm so fucking upset about this. About Shaky Cheese. Did you hear this?
Oh, I did hear about this.
I don't like this.
Because you're a big fan, for people that don't know.
Yeah.
You like that bullshit.
Watch this bullshit.
Watch this bullshit. You like that Kraft cheese.
I do. I love Kraft Shaky Cheese more than I like real shaved Parmesan.
Mm-hmm.
I also take a shit.
Watch this.
Yeah.
And also when I shit and I wipe, I just go to the shower. Those are two things everybody should know about me.
Yeah, yeah. It's so fucking disturbing. I wish you hadn't told everybody about that.
Why? It's fine.
It's so disturbing.
Okay, so here's the problem with my Shaky Cheese. It's laced with exceedingly high levels of cellulose, quote, a common anti-clumping agent made from wood pulp. Wood shavings. In my Shaky Cheese. Fuck. It's delicious. No wonder it's so tasty.
How do you feel about that?
I think I have to stop eating it.
Yeah.
That's really gnarly. I can't do that. I've been eating it my whole life, too. Just wood shavings.
And then you got, you're giving it to your little man, too.
No wonder my dumps are so.
You know?
Yeah, I know. Baby jeans.
Baby jeans is all of a sudden, he's like, where's that wood pulp at, Mom?
Can I tell you what I'm really excited about for our new place that we're moving to?
Mm.
We have a bidet.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, finally, no more shit to shower. I'm going to use a bidet like a lady.
Yeah.
I can't wait.
Are you excited?
I'm really excited. And it's in the downstairs bathroom.
So I have to shit down there so I can clean up.
Lick my ass. Lick my ass. Yeah. Lick it.
It's my boyfriend.
That's the bidet.
Yeah. Yeah. The bidet licks your ass.
You're talking to the bidet.
Lick my ass.
Yeah, I'm kind of excited. I mean, I actually have a much greater need for a bidet than you because I have a lot of hair down there. So, you know, I usually wet a bunch of paper. It's a whole process.
Terrible.
I know. But now I just have just a warm stream of water.
But you tell me that you don't look at the paper.
I don't.
Then how do you know it's clean?
And I don't look in the bowl.
How do you know that it's clean?
Just till it, when it hurts bad, I stop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So does it hurt every day?
Yeah.
You shit so much this weekend. I feel like
I didn't. I had totally normal shits.
It's not that it's abnormal, but your norm is that you're constantly shitting.
No, it's not. You're making it sound like I have diarrhea, and I don't.
No, it's not the diarrhea. It's just that you're always shitting. Like, we're watching Downton Abbey. I gotta take a shit. Or, like, I'm playing with a kid. I gotta shit. You're shitting all day. Like, is there a time you're not shitting?
Yes. All the time in between those shits. I only shit, like, three times.
Nobody shits three times a day.
Yeah, they do.
Vegans.
Vegan vaginas.
Vegan vaginas,
yeah, they do.
Vegan vagina.
But your diet's not that great. Like, why?
No, my diet's not that great.
Hey, I'm talking about, you feel me? I mean.
And then you fucking bring me treats that I didn't even ask for.
I know. Because I love you.
I know.
I love you. Anyway, that's
really
upsetting.
You know what the hardest thing is? Is to knock out sugar. It's so hard.
Oh, I know.
I feel like a fucking sugar. I am a sugar addict.
You think?
Yeah, absolutely.
That's your Achilles heel?
Yes.
Is the sugar.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I could probably turn down a lot of, like, the foods that are, you know, you shouldn't be eating, but sugar is hard to resist.
Well, it's in everything.
Not even started to resist. It's hard to avoid it for an extended period. In other words, I can avoid sugar at breakfast. I can avoid sugar at lunch. By dinner, by the evening, I can start to feel the sugar withdrawal. Mm. And I really want sugar.
But you're talking about just the sweet treats. Because there's sugar in so much of our food.
I'm saying if I avoid it altogether, not just something a sweet, you know, obviously sugar made food. I'm saying if you consciously try to avoid sugar through the day, you can. But I'm saying the effects,
it's so hard too.
Yeah, I feel withdrawal badly. Yeah.
I'm sorry, jeans.
Oh, it's okay. It's okay, mommy. You know, it's fine.
I need like pasta and carbohydrates and cheese.
Which is
stuff.
You know, turns into sugar.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. But I can't do that no carb diet shit. I know Joe's doing it right now on Instagram. I saw him.
Yeah.
That makes me go bananas if I can't have pasta,
I think it makes
or rice.
Everyone
kind
of go bananas, but it's really about how you want to, you know, what do you want to do?
Yeah.
It's hard. I know, it's depressing to me to think about.
I was just thinking last night. You're so funny. We had a conversation. Can we talk about it? It was funny. I was laughing on the way here.
To me, the funniest thing was that I didn't realize for the last, how long now? 6 months?
Yeah.
That I was offensive.
Yeah.
So I'll just say what happened.
Yeah.
So we were at a wedding in August. It was the last trip you could take because you were preggers and you're getting into the third trimester. And we were hanging out and the actual wedding ceremony had finished and people stepped outside of the church and they had a reception directly in this area next door to it. So people are having drinks and, you know, socializing. And I'm just kind of making the rounds, and one of my sisters comes up to me, and she goes, and I was telling you the story that it stuck with me that I thought she overreacted because my sister came up to me and she goes, oh hey, you know you got to get Christina a push present because she's gonna have a baby, and I said, yeah, no shit, and then my sister cried immediately and pretty intensely. And I told you the story last night, and you go, yeah, that's really mean.
Well, your response is really rude. You don't go, yeah, no shit. And the way you said it wasn't like, duh, no shit. It was like, no shit, dummy. Like, you really, it was rude.
Yeah, no, I yeah. Looking back, I said it really rudely.
Yeah.
But
no shit is the worst response to anybody. It's the rudest thing to say to anyone. Especially you when you do it. No shit.
Wait, why especially me?
Because you say it extra shitty.
What?
You're extra, you get an extra attitude.
Extra?
No shit. Duh.
What you told
me? If you said that to me, I'd be like, go fuck yourself. Who the fuck do you think you're talking to? Are you crazy? How the fuck you lost your damn mind? If you said no shit like that.
She was so upset by it.
Of course. It was so rude. Who says that?
Man.
No shit.
Because I can remember it vividly.
Yeah.
Around that patio. And she goes, hey, you know, you got to get Christina a push present. I go, yeah, no shit. And she got so mad.
What? Like, do you know why you were, just irritated with her already?
Yes. And I think if you want to strip away the, you know.
Because it doesn't warrant that responsibly.
I guess not.
Yeah. it would warrant like a, oh, yeah, that's right. I've been thinking about getting her this.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, there's a lot of layers to it with siblings, you know, so for me, it was, I was obviously defensive, and it's about my sibling trying to be the teacher in the moment.
Oh gosh.
You know, like, hey, you know, there's this thing, I don't know if you know about it, it's called a push present, that you get it for somebody. Then I was like, I know, you fucking retard. So,
jeez.
It's just it's a sibling thing, you know. I don't know. Is it that bad?
No.
I think it's probably a lot of siblings are like
that. I'm sure, dude. I don't know. I'm an only child.
I think a lot of them are like, yeah, no shit, you dumb fuck. So
but Maria would have responded.
Maria would have had a different if I would have been like, yeah, no shit, she'd be like, well, I don't know your fucking problem. Yeah, she would have been way more aggro, like,
yeah. Fuck yeah.
She'd be like, Tommy's got a raw attitude today. Maybe you need to go jerk off or something because you got a lot of fucking attitude. She would have been way more fired up.
Nah.
Yeah, my older sister got just more hurt by
She's a little more sensitive. Yeah.
Yeah. But no, the funny thing to me wasn't even that. It was that in telling you the story, you made me realize how crazy my response was.
Horrible response to somebody.
Really?
Especially at a wedding. Like, everybody's in a good mood. We just watch two people we love get married, and we're all dressed nice.
Yeah.
And she's like, oh, yeah, your wife's pregnant. This is a happy time.
Yeah.
And she just made an innocent suggestion, and you were so, like, cantankerous, you know?
Yeah.
No shit.
Yeah, my thing was, like, you can't tell me anything. I think that was... That was internally what was going on. I was just going, like, you're not one to inform me of anything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I know.
I feel badly now, but I feel like it'd be weird to bring it up. Hey, you remember 6 months ago when I said no shit? It'd be weird to bring up, right?
Yeah, you should just let that one go.
You let it go. And the next time she says something, you'd be like, oh.
Yeah.
You know, I did know that, but I'm going to act like it's not a big fucking deal that you're telling me now.
Why is it so annoying when people tell you to do stuff where you're like, look, I do stuff my way, okay? Don't tell me how to fucking do it. This is how I do it here.
I mean, it still would bother me to this day.
Of course.
If it was happening right now, if she was like, you know, something you should do.
Yeah.
But it kind of is annoying when anyone does that.
Of course.
Have you taken your son yet to get, you know what I mean? Like, when people have their suggestions.
That's
of what,
the worst.
Yeah, and you're like, I got it, thanks.
Don't tell me how to do shit with my kid.
Don't tell me how to do anything.
Yeah.
Unless I ask you. You know what it is? It's unsolicited advice.
Yes.
Nobody likes unsolicited advice. You know, we get it as comedians.
Oh, my God.
When you're at a show. And then I even get email. I've gotten emails from people that go, hey, man, I was watching your special, and I thought of a really great punchline for this joke. And I just read it, and I don't respond. I mean, that stuff doesn't upset me because I just feel like it's a crazy person.
Yeah.
But, yeah, when people who know you start going like, you know how you could better live your life?
Oh, my God. Okay. Especially for me as a woman, I'm not very good at womanly things. I don't give a fuck about cleaning, decorating, sewing. You know what I mean? I'm not good at these lady things. Mm-hmm. I just don't give a fuck. And when other women come over and they notice that I'm deficient in this area and then I get schooled on how to be a woman,
yeah.
that makes me bonkers.
Yeah.
You know what? The curtains would be... I don't give a fuck. Well, okay? This is not like my domain.
One of the...
I write shit jokes for a living. This is not where my energy goes, you know?
I totally understand.
Jesus Christ.
It's kind of why I was telling you that even with regard to a move, I don't want... a lot of outsiders there.
Yeah, I know.
Because I don't want the influence of people who go, you know what I would do here?
Yeah. Go fuck yourself.
Yeah, no shit. Yeah. It's what...
Yeah, put the couch up your ass.
Yeah.
No one wants it.
This room could really use... There's these light fixtures that I'm a big fan of. Why don't you put them in your fucking cooch?
In your pussy
see if that
hair.
Lights up. Yeah. Yeah.
Especially us... Because we're real, like, we're big on utility, okay? Mm. I don't know if you, our couch that we got, it's a lazy boy.
There's a motor
in
our new sofa that you press the button and then.
Two recliners.
Yeah.
Because, why? We're white trash.
Yeah.
And I like having cup holders.
Speak for yourself.
And recliners.
Yes, I know.
And that's how I like it. And guess what? There's not going to be a fancy
couch. You're white trash. I'm more.
Ting tong, ting tong. Ting tong, ting tong. Ting tong, ting tong.
Yeah.
But don't come and tell me I should have nice things. This is how we live.
No, I also,
okay?
I really hate.
Okay. Well,
I think it goes back to unsolicited.
Yeah.
People's design ideas.
Oh.
Like if you're volunteering your idea without being asked, you're an asshole. Oh. No one wants to hear your fucking idea.
Yeah, and I eat off paper plates, and we have plastic utensils.
I'm gonna get it with this too. With this episode, people are gonna be like, you know, with regard to the sugar that you were talking about, what I would do, fuck you.
Yeah, if I wanted to change it, I would change it. I would ask.
Yeah,
we're happy. We do it. We do it our way.
All I said was it's hard. Fuck your advice. I'm going to hear it.
I know, Jeans.
I'm hearing your fucking advice. Shit. No shit.
No shit. Really fired up, huh?
Yeah.
I know.
If you're looking to lose weight, you could try doing more exercise and eating healthier. Yeah. No fucking shit.
Well, I think, too, what's infuriating is that it comes from a nice place when people are trying to give you unsolicited advice.
Yeah.
So you know they want to help you.
Yeah.
I don't know. It just infuriates me.
You know they want to help you, but masked under that, I want to help you, is a sense of superiority.
Yeah.
And that's why you get defensive to it.
Yeah.
Because there's an implied sense of, I am the one that could help you with this.
I know how to do this right, and you're not doing
and
it
you're not
right.
doing it right.
My mother was a total asshole
somebody
like that.
Who
yeah.
just says,
God damn it.
Have you thought about getting a push present? Gets you to go, no shit.
Yeah. It's a real Hungarian thing, too.
I snapped, really. I now that you remind me of it, I really said it too harshly.
But because that's a trigger. We both had... my mother was a very controlling, you know how you should do these things? And like, shut the fuck up. You know, we have that in our families. People who tell us how we should be doing shit all the time.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like, you know what you I don't want to know, bro.
Yeah.
I don't want to know.
Yeah.
Well, you went somewhere, huh? Yeah. I saw you in your eyes. You just went somewhere. Where'd you go?
Somewhere violent.
Yeah, I saw it in your face. That's the killer in you just came out. Shit. You're dork-sided.
Dork-sided.
It's coming out.
Yeah.
Coming out.
Coming out. So earlier we had internet troubles, and now we don't have them anymore. We played Kimbo talking about abstaining from sex.
Yeah.
Then I tried to set up the Conor McGregor clip, and the internet went down. I just think you'll love this guy's attitude. You don't know who he is, but he's a superstar in the UFC. And he's being asked by somebody that, you know, he's basically being asked, people are saying that you're kind of doing whatever you want, is the interviewer asking him, okay? And then here's what he...
People are just too quick to say, oh, Conor's picking what he wants, Conor's doing what he wants.
Picking what I want, and I am doing what I want. When you can rack up $400 million in revenue for the company in back-to-back events, you can do whatever the fuck you want. I'm living the whatever the fuck I want life. That's the life I live. Whatever I want, whenever I want. And I have earned that through hard work, through sacrifice, and that's it, through victory.
I love that guy. That's my life philosophy, dude.
Yeah.
I feel like I love him. I love it.
I am doing whatever the fuck I want.
True.
True hard work and true victory.
They don't go th.
True.
There's true.
Yeah. I'm doing whatever the fuck I want.
Whatever the fuck I want.
Whatever the fuck I want.
You're good.
It's in my lucky charms. I eat 6 bowls a day. Because I got so much fucking money now.
Where's that going?
They're saying that you're doing whatever the fuck you want. No shit!
I really like this guy.
We should alarm her a little bit.
Oh, yeah. Let her get some. I really? Oh, fuck them. I'm so sick of these neighbors.
Oh, fuck.
Go
me.
Fuck themselves, yeah. Too, big time.
Yeah, I'm doing whatever the fuck.
Whatever the fuck. Hey, I like this guy. Does he talk more about stuff?
He talks all
I
kinds
feel like
of
he
shit.
He needs a podcast.
He's a big old shit talker.
Good
He's great.
For him.
He's great, man.
I'm living the whatever the fuck I want life.
That's
a great life.
That is a great life. Whatever the fuck I
but
want.
You do have to earn that life. That
of
life
course.
Isn't given to you. Yeah.
Of course. Hard work. Sacrifice.
Sacrifice. And true hard work and true victory. Good for him.
Fuck.
Speaking of, you know what I'm saying, one of the
retarded
clips that we've played in the past has to be of this young man who is telling you what he's looking for. I believe in a mate. Do you know what I'm talking about?
No.
Yeah.
A guy, we've played a clip of him saying that he just wants someone to get real fat with and...
Oh, right. Okay.
You know what I'm talking about? You feel me? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's not that guy.
That's not the guy. It's a different guy. So this guy, is it him?
It's your mom's house, that guy.
That's your mom's house.
You Jew motherfucker, you.
That's not him.
My mom's house.
This guy, where did he go? You know what I'm talking about? You feel me? You know what I'm saying?
No.
And he had that crazy laugh.
Oh, that guy's right. We just feed each other and get fat. Yeah. Kai.
That's not Kai.
Oh.
No, that's not Kai. Where did everything go? Why is everything so confusing, Jeans?
That's because you're old.
I'm old?
You're dead. When are you going to start wearing socks with rubber sandals? Like
Pretty
our
soon.
Neighbor.
Pretty soon.
That was horrible. We walked past our neighbor.
Yeah.
Total dad mode. He was wearing like black socks.
Yeah.
With navy blue, like Adidas slipper. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Like those swimmer slippers.
Yeah.
Like, dude, you just fucking straight gave up. And he's wearing shorts, working on the car. You're like, God, your fucking life is over. And he's like our age. He's not
that
much older than me.
No. And he just got a really nice car, so we were talking about his car to him.
Well, because we're super proud of him. Like, good for you, bro. You got, like, you didn't cave and get a minivan.
A fucking dad car.
Yeah, like, you got, like, a dope-ass ride, but your gear's all fucked up, you know?
Your gear's whack as shit.
Yeah, like, why do you have to dress like a dad or mom to be a parent? It's so weird.
Yeah.
Something, it's like dad mouth, too.
I'm a fucking nice person.
Yeah.
I can cook like a motherfucker, make some fucking straight-up fucking grub, fucking chicken fried steak, fucking collard greens, fucking mashed potatoes, all that fucking good-ass sausage gravy, biscuits, fucking everything, man. I cook like a motherfucker. I want to find a skinny-ass little bitch and make her fat, and we can lose weight together, and we'll bond.
That guy is fucking phenomenal.
Yeah.
He probably doesn't dress cool either, if I remember correctly.
No.
He's a juggalo. Is that a juggalo thing?
The juggalo, you know, I want to make fun of them a lot more, but I feel like they're decent people. I feel like their message is positive.
I have no actual real issue.
Yeah.
This is just great clips.
Oh, right. Know? Yeah, they're often not the, how do you say, brightest people on the internet.
That was Christina.
No, we get really silly juggalo clips, and then I feel bad because their message is kind of positive and like they're nice.
It's very
people.
Positive. It's always like they're always just like
peace and love and stuff.
Fucking cook a fucking collard greens and fucking sausage and gravy and fucking all this fucking shit. So this came in.
Yeah, what up, your boy Blew Up Boy here. And you might recognize this shirt. This is the same shirt Monoxide was wearing in the Homies video.
Yeah.
I believe Juicy J also wore it in a 3-6 Mafia video, too.
Okay.
But anyways, that's not what the video is about. This video is about the Mighty Dark Carnival and how only real jugglers, true down-ass real jugglers, believe in a dark carnival, believe that the carnival is God, and may all jugglers find them. Motherfacko. And that...
Motherfacko?
Yeah. I hate when that's people try not to curse. Is that what he's doing?
Or is it like a... Is it juggalo slang?
Oh, maybe.
I think it's probably juggalo slang.
Shit.
Hatchet Man is your savior. Now, I mean, you got to pray to the Dark Carnival in the name of the Hatchet Man. You know what I'm saying?
Nope.
So what's so hard, you know, to believe that there's this spiritual, magical realm, you know, where there's a Dark Carnival that judges evil souls that sends them to hell. You know what I'm saying?
Right now, I don't know what you're saying. I don't know what you mean.
It's a lot happening in this clip.
That's intense.
Yeah.
Where he's going. The Dark Carnival.
He's talking about all kinds of nonsense.
Yeah.
I don't know what the fuck he's talking about. Do you understand?
No. No.
This is for a band, right? Like the band. What's the band?
The Insane Clown Posse.
Right. And then they have like Dark Lords and
it sounds like
Underworld.
There's a dark... Basically, it sounds like the Dark Carnival that he's speaking of is just a metaphor for hell or judgment.
Oh,
you know?
Sure. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
And the Dark Lord. I mean, everything is just a symbol of something else, you know?
Yeah.
So,
hmm.
I don't know.
Let's just hope Ellis doesn't get into this shit. Right.
If Ellis shows up, he's like, hey, what's up, faggot, to me. And I'm like, hey. And he goes, where's fucking tits at? And I go, she's in taking a bath. And he's like, Dark Carnival is here.
If you notice, I'm wearing the shirt that MC Search did.
Yeah. And I go, all right.
Whatever.
And he goes, I fucking hate you. And I go, all right. I'm going to a concert this weekend. Bye. I'm taking your car. Peace, dog.
Oh, my God.
Like, dude.
The amount of work we put into him.
What's wrong with you?
I get so upset with him.
And real juggalos go straight to Shangri-La, you know what I mean? If you go to Hell's Pit, then you weren't a real juggalo, motherfucko. Because real juggalos take the message of the Dark Carnival and, you know what I'm saying?
No.
Adapt it to their life, you know what I'm saying?
Oh my God.
It's more than a lifestyle, than a way of life, you know what I'm saying? It's a religion. True, real down-ass juggalos know that magical fucking feeling you get when bumping the shit. You know what I'm saying? Who's behind the juggalo powers? You know what I'm saying?
This kid's got a lot of fucking problems. If our kid does this, we lost him. We lost
Done.
Him.
You failed.
Big time, yeah. You failed as a parent.
Big time. What the fucking nonsense is this guy talking about?
I don't know.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? I don't know. It's, I think it's always, what is it? Misappointed energy?
Misdirected,
yes.
Yeah.
When, yeah. I think whenever you're into any band this much, not just juggalos.
Too much.
If you love, you know, Fish or your Deadhead, and it becomes your identity,
yeah.
There's just another issue with you.
Or like, you know, I go to Michael's Arts and Crafts. I used to a lot. And there's like the purple lady.
Yeah.
Where she wears all purple every day and she's in there.
Yeah.
And you're like, that's my thing. I'm the purple lady. You're like, no. You've got a lot of misdirected creative energy. If
mm-hmm.
you know, it's like the snake guy who walks down the beach. I'm the snake guy. Like,
yeah.
No. You're someone who's got this energy that needs to be directed
somewhere else.
Something productive. Yeah.
I understand that when you find a group that you really want to be a part or, you know, speaks to you.
Yeah.
It's, you know, seductive.
Well, I like the Pixies.
You know? Yeah. But you don't let it be your entire identity. If it was just 24/7 Pixies, I'd be like, there's something really going on with you that you're not addressing. That's the problem here, is that there's something going on that you're not addressing.
Yeah.
You know, you can't just be at the Dark Carnival 24/7.
Yeah. And the Joker cards are all real, motherfucko. There's really a Jake and Jack juggle in your sins. There's really a riddle box that people stand before. You know what I'm saying? There's a real wraith that takes your soul. The only one that's not really real and it's just a symbol is the Carnival of Carnage face. You know what I'm saying? That's just a symbol for...
I'm so confused.
You know what I'm saying?
So confused.
You know, everything that is the ghetto and what have you, the traveling, you know, here on this earthly realm. It's like, you know what I'm saying, you got the Holy Trinity and shit. You got-
I am not lost.
And now he's talking about a deck of cards?
Is this Magic the Gathering? Is that what this is?
I have no idea. I have no idea. It's a lot.
Yeah.
It's a lot.
Trying
now
to
let's
process.
Get to the important part.
Right.
How many no sayings he did?
You know what I'm saying? It's a religion. You know what I'm saying? And I forget what the fuck else, you know what I'm saying? But it's just that real true down ass magical feeling, you know what I'm saying, of the dark carnival. You know what I'm saying?
Fucking idiot. Sorry, you're a fucking idiot.
Yeah. That's safe.
I feel
to
like
say,
somebody
right?
should tell this guy, you're a fucking idiot, and then he should go, no shit. That would be perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah. You got a lot of issues, man.
A lot of problems. Mm-hmm. A lot of free time.
Yeah.
You know, there's so many ills in the world too that this guy could help. I feel like people like him, like if you don't have a direction in life, why not volunteer to hug like adopted newborns or something? Or
do something, right?
Yeah, like go feed the homeless or do fucking something else. Stop wasting your meaningless life with the fucking insane clown posse, weirdo.
Let me read an email to you from a
waste
listener.
Of existence.
From William. Hey, mommies / Hitlers. Confartulations on the arrival of Little Jeans. Longtime denim wearer writing in to suggest that you frame a picture of maybe the hotel or even the room door from the famed Cincinnati fart to hang in the studio.
Yeah.
Secondly, awesome job, Christina, on that steep, bro. Love that shit.
Thanks,
Tom,
bro.
Keep up the vlogs. Last and selfishly, the main reason I'm writing to you, trouble finding denim that fits.
Oh.
A new lifestyle has changed my crotch, thigh, ass area measurements over the past couple of years to the point where I can no longer find denim in store that fits. There are limits to the highness and tightness one can handle. I have reached mine. I need to find better fitting jeans. Heeding Rogan's advice and trying out those stretchy barbell jeans seems to be my best bet out there, but not made of real denim. I need to know if I can wear these. Could you comment in this fake stretchy denim legitimacy, please? Highest and tightest for as long as I can bear it. Bill, P.S. I love you fucking mommies.
I don't know what he's talking about. These barbell jeans?
Yeah, Joe's been wearing them. They basically look like jeans.
Mm-hmm.
They're a different fabric, and they're super stretchy, so you can really move around in them.
I'd like that because I don't mean to talk shit about jeans, but they're really not that comfortable. I'm sorry. I said it. I'm out. I'm wearing maternity jeans. They're comfy. Well, they cut your stomach and everything.
Are maternity jeans, are they made of real denim?
What happens is maternity jeans, yeah, they're real denim, but then right above your pubic bone area, they put like a piece of stretchy spandexy cloth so that you don't feel like a fat load. You know when you button your jeans and it cuts your stomach in two because you're fucking, you know, when you're fat?
Okay,
that's why I don't like the jeans.
I want to tell you this.
Yeah.
You, this guy, and Joe can get out of my life.
Wow.
With your fucking fake jean wearing bullshit. Consider us not friends.
What?
And consider us over.
Wow. That's
consider
really
the
crazy.
Whole thing over.
Are you being serious, Tom?
100%.
What's with the jeans?
100%.
I like these jeans that Joe's speaking of, though.
I think they're called barbell.
I'm going to look into that. Yeah. Wait, do you like the tightness?
Of what?
Of jeans.
It depends on the day. There's some days where I put a pair of jeans on.
Mm-hmm.
Well, here's the thing. Sometimes when you say tight, you assume that it means tight everywhere.
Yeah.
I'm saying if the waist feels comfortable,
yeah,
but it's tight in other places, but it feels good, there's certain days for that.
There's thin days.
Yeah, it's like a thin day, but you like the snugness a little bit.
Yeah.
I don't like that every day, but there's just certain days where that feels good. I'll tell you what I think is way worse, and I'm being serious.
Yeah.
When jeans are too loose on your waist.
Low and loose.
Yes.
I know.
You're pulling them up.
I know.
I hate it.
You're like a homeless guy shuffling.
I hate it with your schizophrenic shuffle, and it's terrible.
I just bought a pair of jeans that were too big like that, and they were low and loose.
Yeah.
and I had to get them tailored.
Yeah,
you there's nothing worse. There's than nothing loose worse. Jeans. Yeah.
I mean, I'm pretty much a purist, and I'm not advocating wearing these you know fake denim jeans. But if you support that kind of lifestyle, you know, we know who's real in this relationship.
Okay. Can I tell you what I really fucking hate? Mm. Light denim.
Oh, it's the worst.
It's so gross.
Our neighbor probably wears those.
Of course.
Whitewashed denim. That's with what sandals.
Dad's, yeah. Dad's wear light denim.
Yeah, he's got the lightest denim on. Yeah.
Or white denim's the worst. You gotta wear dark denim. White denim's
dork.
For...
Dork denim.
Eastern Europeans wear white denim.
Yeah.
I don't mind fake denim. I'm sorry. I guess we're different that way.
We're way different. We're way different. Barbell. I don't know.
I'm going to look that up right now.
You
barbell
are?
Jeans. Yeah. Do they make them for ladies too?
I'm sure they do. I'm sure they do. Hmm. So we haven't addressed this yet today.
Hey, Hitler.
She's really taking over the show.
When your mind is set to fight.
What the fuck?
Either you go.
So I just hit that on accident.
What is happening?
But this is one I didn't expect from Danny, but is also so in line with the show. I don't know if you've heard this yet. This is from Danny.
Are you a Daniac?
I am a Daniac. Okay, are you ready?
Let's hear it, Hitler.
Hey, Harry. It's me, Danny. I just want to tell you that I really do love you a lot, and I really do miss you a lot. And I also want to tell you that the place where I'm actually going to poop in your mouth is actually in your mouth, not actually outside of it. And I probably might smear it on your nose and, you know, on your face and on your chest and, you know, stuff like that. Since I actually love you a lot and, you know, I just want to tell you that I really do miss you and I really do love you and hopefully if you ever need to, I'll be making more videos, okay?
Okay.
Bye. Cheerio, darling.
Wow.
I might be a little late on this, but...
Next stop, Brown Talk.
Damn, dude.
Brown Talk coming up. You've been warned.
Crazy.
Yeah. Yes. Who knows what's going on there? Sorry, I didn't expect that.
Yeah, did you know that was coming?
No, that's not where I thought she would go with that.
Yeah.
But so then again, she vlogs to Hitler, so like, who knows?
Funny that you mentioned that. We get an email from a listener that says, "Hey Hitlers, love the Momcast. It's probably the bestest podcast on the internet, right? Meow.
Thank you.
Maybe even the best show on the planet ever, but yes. I digress. As any Führer fan knows, Mr. Adolf is alive and living at large in Argentina. Uh-huh. Some say it's a conspiracy theory, but I say there's solid evidence of his well-being. A, there's a Wikipedia page dedicated to it.
Okay.
And B, who would post a YouTube video asking for help from a dead man? That would just be insane. Danny has figured it out. The best way to contact Hitler is via YouTube. Everyone will think she's insane, but I bet Hitler is watching and scheming and on something something. You just watch. Hitler is going to pounce. Keep those jeans high and tight. Your big words, Tomas.
That is amazing.
That
so
is
she...
an amazing, amazing point.
Hey, Hitler.
So she really is contacting the Führer.
And she thinks, and this guy says that he's watching these videos like, mm-hmm.
Like, it's like a Dear Abby advice column.
Yeah.
And he's going to
write he's like, I got to figure out how to get that guy out of that belly button. Yeah. Yes. I think that is what's going on.
That's really amazing.
It's a great
wow.
Great
That's great. So funny, dude. Hitler. Maybe, you know, who knows? He could be in Argentina. We don't have his corpse, do we?
We don't. No.
We don't know.
No. No one's ever found his corpse.
So he could be with all the other asshole Nazis in Argentina.
Could be. Just walking around Buenos Aires. Yep. Having a good old time. Just watching Danny videos. on his iPhone, just walking around like, Yeah.
Thank you, Danny. The Daniacs.
Danke, Danny. Yeah. Let's see what I can conjure up today. Oh, he only watches Danny's stuff.
That's amazing if that were the case. Not true, Daniac.
Danny Jeans, with her video, got me...
Hi, I got a screw loose, and this is my sequel to the doo-doo song.
Okay.
I believe I can crap.
Got me thinking that this is a song we can play.
When I'm alone and feeling sad.
I don't think this one's going to get flagged.
All I want is to sit all day on the toilet. Please don't go away.
Pretty good.
I get what she's doing.
Play with my crap every day. Smear it on my face.
What's happening? What's happening?
I don't know.
Put it in my mouth and say.
Who's doing this?
I believe I can crap.
It's a good song.
Did she listen to our show?
I believe I can crap. I believe I can crap till day.
Yeah.
Good.
I believe I can crap. I believe I can touch my crap.
Yeah.
Be with my crap both night and day.
You get the idea.
They get it. This isn't Daniac, though.
No, somebody totally different. Yeah.
Obviously a fan of your mom's house.
Obviously a fan, but, you know, I thought that it kind of played well with Danny's video.
It does go hand in hand. What's with smearing it on the face? That's a...
I don't know.
That's a thing.
This person was talking about smearing it on their own face.
Right.
Whereas Danny was going to do it to the man she loves, on his nose and in his mouth.
Some people are really into that. That's the crazy thing.
Mm-hmm.
How much would it take for you to do that?
No.
To do what?
Smear crap on my crap on your face?
Oh. A lot more than you have. It would take a lot. That's so fucking disgusting.
Yeah, I'm not into that.
That's the most disgusting thing you can do.
Yeah.
I try to respect people's quirks and fetishes, but that's a hard one to embrace.
That's one I don't understand at all.
It's just
It's not hygienic either.
Hygienic.
Not good.
No. God.
Really not good. That's fucking nutty, dude.
It's the most upsetting thing that somebody can do is to
I think you're right.
Yeah.
In terms of fetishes, I would say that might be the only one that I'm like, oh no, vomiting. I think the vomit fetish, I'm not interested in that, and pooping.
Yeah.
Pee is like big deal.
Oh damn.
Yeah.
Urine can be sterile, but
If we started dating and I was like, oh, I want you to shit on me now.
Yeah. It'd be a deal breaker.
Yeah, it would.
That might be one of the few.
Yeah. I can't get into it either, man. I can't imagine, wanting to do that.
Oh my God, you guys are so disgusting.
It's so gross.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can we do Would You Rathers?
You want to do it right now?
Well, just sometime today.
Okay, we can.
I have one for you.
You do?
Yeah.
All right. Sure. Just give me a few. We have a couple other things to get to.
Okay.
Hi, Kathy Mitchell here with my new Dunk Cake Cookbook. It's as simple as dunk and bake. Watch this. Start with fruit, dump on your favorite cake mix, and finish with a can of soda. Then just bake it in the oven for a delicious raisin peach dunk cake. Oh, so scrumptious. For fresh, warm, sticky buns, just like Grandma used to make. Yummy pineapple upside dump cake. But wait, call now and get my amazing dump dinner cookbook. Don't even brown the beef. Dump in uncooked pasta and sauce. Top with cheese and cook. You'll get both cookbooks, dump cakes and dump dinners, for just $10.
So funny. I like that.
That's our little interlude now. So thank you, Kathy, and everyone at Dump Cakes.
Our new sponsor.
Thursday Lane, Diego.
Yes.
Was on Tosh.0.
Yes.
A lot of people messaged us about it. And yes, we definitely saw that you saw him. We were very happy for him.
Of course.
It's huge exposure for Diego.
And for a good cause.
A man wants farts.
Yeah.
And I'm happy that he was on the show. And then Diego, a.k.a. Thursday Lane, posted a video thanking us.
Oh, that's sweet.
So I thought that was very nice of him.
That's really nice.
Here we go.
Hi, Christine. I just want to say thank y'all so much for putting my wish list out there. I thank you, your mom's house. I appreciate y'all. I'm celebrating here with this cake.
What's the cake?
You know, I'm celebrating with this nice cake. I'm going to have a piece of cake. Thank you, Tom and Christina. Whoever see my YouTube video, show this to your mama's house, Tom and Christina. Thank y'all. I love y'all so much. Thank you. One day, I like to make it up to y'all.
That's sweet.
Maybe one day I can hire y'all in one of my one of my animation soaps.
Okay.
Maybe.
Okay.
All right.
Maybe.
Thank you, Thursday Lane.
Thank you. Not one of your
no.
But it was very funny that he was on Tosh, and I think it's very sweet of Thursday, who wants those farts, to give us a shout.
Wow. Isn't that crazy that he's gone mainstream?
Yeah,
like
great,
this
man.
All started from, this actually came from a listener submission. One of our listeners sent in his video, and there was like 30 video views on it.
Yeah.
And now look at him now, big celebrity.
Big celeb. Yeah.
So let's hope that he makes that porno that he wants.
Yeah, now he's...
dreams come true.
Yeah, he literally had about 13 views on a video. Now that first video we played has 104,000 views.
Wow.
And the next one that we played, which had a few views, has 29,000.
Wow. Wow. Well, there you go. It just shows when you have something to give, when you have a positive message that you need to give to the world.
Yeah.
The waters part. Hey, can I bring up something before I forget?
Yeah.
Dude, Big Ange died.
Oh.
From massage, facial, get spray tan. Hello.
We used to play that years ago.
Big
For
Ange.
Those of people that don't know, there was a VH1 show called Mob Wives, and it had really some entertaining folks on it, of whom the most entertaining was Big Ange.
Yeah.
And then she got her own spinoff show.
Yeah, which was okay. I watched the first season, and then I kind of lost interest.
Yeah, I don't think it lasted that much longer anyways.
I don't know.
But anyways, it's sad that she had cancer, I think, right?
Yeah, she died of cancer. She was smoking and drinking and partying, you know? I don't know.
She lived it up.
She had huge fake tits, huge fake lips. She was really quite a personality.
Yeah.
But I'm sad. I really liked Big Ange. I thought she was cool.
Very,
and rest in peace.
Rest in peace.
Massage, facial, and spray tan. Do it in heaven.
Yeah, there's definitely that. What did I want to tell you? I got this.
Hello. I got to pee.
You do?
Really bad.
You want me to stop right now?
Please, mommy.
Okay, 1 second.
Hello.
All right, we're back from the official pee break. How was your pee?
It was good. I pushed hard and it all came out.
That's great.
They tell you to push hard when you have to pee.
Yeah, that's one of the big things about peeing is they say push as hard as you can. Grab the side of the bowl, hold on, and push as hard as you can when you pee or brown.
And wait as long as you can before you have to go, too. Mm-hmm. Nice and full.
Should hurt. Should be really... Doctors will tell you, make sure you're in pain before you go. That's the natural rhythm of the body. Pain, 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 release.
Oh, olé.
It's time to fill her up and
seal her shut.
All right. Get your dicks out and hard.
Oh, my
here.
God. Okay. Let's not get carried away, Thursday Lane.
So, it's Black History Month. We are going to do Fill Her Up, Seal Her Shut, Black Award-Winning Actress.
Oh, okay.
You understand,
all
Theo?
All right. I see what you're saying.
So, here we go. Up first, SAG award-winning actor Idris Elba.
Oh, we met him in South Africa.
Or Academy Award-winning actor Denzel Washington. Now,
Denzel
has been the go-to for a lot of people for a lot of years. But I just want to point out, first of all, he still looks great. You know, if you're looking to get that ism in you.
Can I see Idris, though? I forget what he looks like.
You forget what he looks like?
Yeah.
He's a fucking handsome devil.
I know we met him in South Africa, and everybody was like, oh, my God, this guy's really famous.
Yeah,
and I'm like, who? And then
I mean,
he's super nice to us. Oh, yeah, he's handsome.
Yeah.
I thought he was younger.
I mean, he's He's a good-looking guy, though, right?
Mm-hmm. He looks mild-mannered. Can I tell you who I'm going to go for?
Well, it sounds
Denzel.
Like...
Denzel!
But is it because he's classic Denzel?
I like... No, I like his teeth. I like the shape of his teeth. Yeah. And I think that he's more of a savage. Like, Idris seems like he's just, like, a nice guy.
Oh, I so disagree, but go ahead,
I think that Denzel, behind closed doors, like, he's all suave.
Yeah. But this guy's suave, too.
He'll slay your cooch, you know? Like, you really give it a prison pounding. Like, oh, my God.
And you don't think Idris will?
No. I think he's more, like, he looks sweeter. He's nice. We met him. He's too sweet.
We met him, but we didn't fuck him. So we're still guessing, you know?
Yeah. I think Denzel beats it up and tosses it out, as you say. Oh, yeah, that's right. There he is. Yeah, there you are.
I don't know.
God, that's a long time
reads.
Ago.
Yeah.
How many weeks ago is that?
175.
Yeah.
Yes. So what is that?
Crazy. I don't know. I can't
it's
do
It's almost
that.
3 years? Yeah. More than 3 years? Yeah, it's more than 3 years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
South Africa, that's the first time I sharted.
Yeah.
On the plane ride over.
That's right. You had tacos.
Both of us, yeah.
No, you did. I didn't.
You didn't have tacos with me?
No.
That's why you didn't shart.
Exactly.
Yeah, I sharted.
Atlanta, Hartsfield, yeah. Jackson, you had tacos before the international Atlanta to Johannesburg flight. And then you took your panties off because you sharted.
But I had a spare backup pair.
Really clever of you.
In my carry-on. But I did shart for the first time.
Back to the loads. Yeah. I'm going 100% with Idris Elba.
I knew you would.
I feel like, you know, I feel like Denzel has been on the mountaintop for so long that he's always just grabbing you by the back of your head, putting it in between his butt cheeks.
I love him.
And he's just going, eat your dinner. And it's just like a command.
Eat your dinner.
And he's not even happy that you did it. Like, he's like, I've had better. Just totally taking everything for granted. Now, Idris is a smooth dude, and he gets laid, I'm sure, a lot. But I still feel like it's going to be... He's gonna drag you. He'll drag you by your hair, but he's going to appreciate what you do. And he's, you know, I'm sure he'll do that thing where he wipes his dick on your forehead when he's done.
That's so funny, because I thought that's what Denzel would do to you. I was going to say the same thing.
Yeah, well, I think Denzel will wipe his ass on your forehead. But I think Idris would just wipe his dick there.
Yeah.
And I feel like, I don't know, I feel like Idris is the new dick of the month.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he's really pulled his dick out and put it on top of the mountain. And he's trying to get Denzel's dick off of the mountaintop.
Mm.
So I'm just going to go with Idris Elba.
What a wonderful assessment.
Yeah. I think it'll be cooler, and then I'll ask him stories about The Wire, and I'll be like, how'd you do that accent?
Oh, because you love that. Yeah. What's the accent that he did?
Well, he sounded like just an American dude, you know?
Oh, and he's from
British. And it's
always
like,
British.
He's so good at, you would never assume that he's doing an accent. Because it's not just he's doing American, he's speaking, he's doing like, you know, the slang of U.S. culture so naturally. That it doesn't even occur to you.
Isn't that amazing? Yeah. People like the guy, Officer Brody on Homeland. Is he Australian or New Zealander or something?
Yeah.
You wouldn't know. I didn't know the whole time I was watching that show. Okay, now here's the thing. But Denzel, I see what you're saying. That Idris is like newer and more enthusiastic.
Listen.
Forget the beating. It ain't about that. You smart, man. I could see that. I wanted you to choose somewhere safe for us to speak, but goddamn. Only bugs and this motherfucker gonna have legs.
And he's South African.
No, he's not South African.
I appreciate smart. But you gotta know in this game, man, it ain't enough. You a student of history?
Do you hear him speak there, right?
I mean,
and then here is...
His big break came.
Hold on.
Just like that?
I said, okay. Thanks, Tom.
But do you feel more or less pressure to take a role like that if it comes with the caveat that Tom Cruise said no?
Actually, I'm not sure if that was a rumor or a joke.
Guillermo
del Toro has a huge sense of humor. But, yeah, of course, you know, the role was a coveted role.
That's that dude.
You know, this town had a share of smart players, man.
Wow.
Melvin, Little Will.
See, I'd be like, dude, do different accents as you fuck me.
Right. Which one would you prefer, though?
Well, I'd be like, I'm a master of accents also. Let's do them to each other. And he'd be like,
Ed Bubba, Peanut Warren.
And I'd be like, hello, mate. Keep fucking.
Oh, real smart, man. Real smart.
You're smart, too.
And what's his tagline when he jizzes? You know, the porno.
Oh, his porno
the line.
Tag?
Yeah.
I think he would say something like, well, it depends which accents he's doing.
Do the British one.
Oh, I think he'd go, cheerio, mate.
Cheerio, mate.
Cheerio, Hitler.
Like Daniacs.
Yeah, like Daniac. Cheerio, Hitler. Like that.
And that's the cheerio, Hitler. They always have to do it on the beat, right?
Say hello to Hitler.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like that. And he'd be like, turn around. Wipe it on your head.
Oh, God.
You know, as soon as their names rang out.
It's crazy,
so
right?
Stupid.
That dude's a great actor.
And I'm sure Tom would have loved to have done it. I'm sure
he's talking about you.
Oh, yeah, he's
Tom would have
me.
Loved to have do me. And then he's talking about your guys' sexual sessions.
Yeah.
I think that Denzel, because he's been in the game longer, he's had so much poon, he's more creative. He's going to make you do things like lick his toes, really get in there.
Maybe a violent.
Lick his armpits. You might rub shit on your face, that kind of stuff.
You want those armpits?
No. But Denzel will make you do stuff like that.
But you think...
It's varsity.
And then all of a sudden you realize you did it, and what happened? You think that's probably how it is, right? He kicks you out when he goes, get out, when he's done.
Like Bukowski. He, get out of here.
He finishes, and he goes, get out.
Yeah.
And then you walk out of the room, and you go... I just licked that guy's armpit for 30 minutes.
There you go. That's exactly the experience
that's pretty cool.
with Denzel.
That's pretty cool. I think when somebody degrades you, but you don't realize that it happened in the moment, that's pretty cool.
He's a boundary crosser, and then you go home, and you're like, what the fuck did I just do?
And you call your girlfriend, and you're like, how many times have you licked a guy's armpit for like half an hour? And she's like, what? And you go, this guy Denzel made me do it.
Yeah.
And I did it, and then I was licking his chode. And
yeah. She's like, Denzel Washington? And I'm like, how many Denzels are there in the world?
Yeah, there's two Denzels, him and another guy. Yeah.
There's not many Denzels. I've only ever heard of one.
Denzel Perryman.
Who's that?
I think he's a football player.
Oh, okay. Well, and there's that Denzel.
Well, okay.
Really neat topic. Thank you for doing that.
Anyways, so we voted there. Let's see what the listeners do. Make sure you vote. I think there's always a link to votes. If you go to facebook.com/yourmomshousepodcast, they always, a listener sets up a place that you can actually vote on the filler up and sealer shots.
Yeah.
It's very exciting. Okay, so we continue. Black History Month, award-winning actors, females, Taraji Henson or Viola Davis. Now, Taraji's on the show. What was it? Is she on Empire, or is somebody else on Empire? What the fuck? She just won something. Sorry, I'm trying to make sure I got her plug right. I wouldn't want her to get upset with what.
You know, she's gonna hear this, and she's gonna be really upset with you.
And I get the phone call, Tom. You just...
You know what show I'm on.
You just... she's on Empire. And she just won, and
Let me look her up.
Here she is.
She gave a really crazy speech. I don't watch the award shows. I happened to catch a minute of it, and she gave a cray-cray speech.
Wasn't she kind of loaded?
She was lit.
She was bruised,
she
right?
was like, this is what I deserve. I'm a fucking... You know, she's kind of an asshole. Yeah, a little bit.
Ooh.
Kind of an asshole. Oh, okay, titties.
Okay.
She got them titties out.
Is that speech, I'm sure it's widely available.
She just was very arrogant and like, she was running the light and she was like, I can say what the fuck I want. I earned this shit.
Oh, it was the Golden Globes that she won. Okay, yeah.
She was kind of drunk, I thought.
And she gave a crazy speech. That's what this says.
Oh, shit, it says it on...
Cookies for everyone tonight.
Yeah, yeah.
My street. Hollywood Foreign Press. Thank you. I mean, who knew that playing an ex-convict would take me all around the globe? It just goes
off the show. I thought it would be Queenie. Will, I thought it would be my character from, you know, Karate Kid. But it's Cookie, who spent 17 years in jail for selling crack. Okay. So the world loves real. Thank you. So many people to thank.
It looks like it goes on and on.
Yeah, she's kind of weird.
And then Viola Davis.
Yeah, she's real popular.
Yeah. She won. She just won an award. Did she win a SAG award? Or was it a Golden Globe? Or both? Which one was it? It looks like she won. Why is this so hard when the moment you want to pull it up? Viola Davis. She won an award. Okay. Emmy Award for Outstanding Lead Actress. How to Get Away with Murder. She won the Emmy for that. And she just won another award at one of these. Who knows? There's so many fucking awards, right?
Yeah.
So it's really...
It matters, Tom. These awards mean everything.
So we know that Taraji gets lit. So we know that.
She likes to party. But yeah. She's a little bougie. She's a little high maintenance, it sounds like.
And here's
Viola Davis. She's great. Yeah. She's been in everything. Oh, I like her.
So I think we have... But I think it's very... You're getting two very distinct styles probably in the bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
You know, one's kind of a booze bag, sounds like. Mm-hmm. And
Viola's a lady.
This is a lady.
She's a lady.
So are you going to fill up and seal shut? And what's your reasoning?
Well, if you want to devastate somebody, if you want to make them cry, if you want to haunt their memories, you're going to do Viola, you personally.
This woman here?
The nice lady. You want to traumatize her.
Oh, right.
The other one is just
She's
a straight pig.
Yeah.
Yeah. She'll do whatever you want.
Yeah. That's interesting.
That's, I mean, it's a style thing. Do you want to hurt somebody or do you want, you know,
Well, I already feel like Taraji was talking a lot of shit in her acceptance speech.
Yeah.
And that shit's going to get old with a dick in her mouth.
Okay.
I feel like Viola is more my cup of tea to break her spirit, to mold her into the piggy that I'm trying to make.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I feel like the other Henson's going to be just like, oh, yeah, I remember this one time I was in Beirut and there were these three guys and she's like going to be comparing you to stuff she's done before.
Been there, done that.
There, done that. And she's like, oh, that's not that big and that doesn't hurt that much.
Yeah.
Whereas Viola's going to be like, I have a family.
I'm scared.
Can I go now? I'm like, shut up. Yeah.
That's what I'm thinking with you. Yeah. I knew you'd pick that one.
So yeah, Viola. How about you?
Well, I'm not as experienced as you are. I haven't done as much. I need a pig to turn me out. You know what I mean?
Oh, so you take
Taraji. I'm going to go with the other one. Yeah, because she's kind of a bitch. I feel like she would just take over and I could just kind of hang out and not do much. So that'd be cool.
So that's who you're going with?
Yeah.
Okay.
I let her have a pig party on me.
Okay. Pig party. Taraji Henson. She'd probably be drunk during it, don't you think?
It'd be fun. Yeah, we'd get fucked up and I'd be like, I've never done this before. And she'd be like, I've done it.
Yeah.
Oh, here's how. And then she'd show me how to do stuff. I'm like, oh, that's crazy.
True. True.
It'd be a good story.
All right. Well, let's do this and get out of here, okay?
Yeah. Masterful work on your part.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
I was really impressed that you did that on the beat.
We need
a
contest. I just realized this.
Yeah.
Because of our licensing things are going to come up, why don't we do a Would You Rather theme song contest?
That would be a great idea.
consider the floodgates are open. Send in a Would You Rather theme song. Originally, it was a Cosby Jell-O remix. Then he raped a bunch of people. Right now, we have a placeholder, but it's a Gloria Estefan song. So why don't we have an original Would You Rather theme song contest? You send it in. Send in, you know, something you can say Would You Rather in it. It can have nothing to do with that, but it'll be the prompt for Would You Rathers.
It's a good idea, James.
Send them to yourmomspodcast@gmail.com. There's no house in the email address. yourmomspodcast@gmail.com. Jeans, what's your Would You Rather?
Okay, finally. Yeah. I've been dying to fucking do this one. Okay, so Would You Rather? Okay. You have to lick Phoebe's mouth. Like, lick it. Like, see his little black lip. Like, he's got lips.
Yeah, the foo-foo.
Yeah.
You got to lick his lips and his beard. Like, you know how he goes in the backyard and he licks in the dirt and he comes in and it's covered in dirt. And just, you've smelled his mouth. Like, his mouth smells like a fucking fish market.
Yeah.
And it's so gross. And his teeth are all cruddy.
Mm-hmm.
You got to lick the fur around his mouth, his lips, and his teeth.
Yeah.
Lick that up. Or every time you got to go potty, number one and number two, you have to go outside with the dogs.
Every time?
I let you out. I'd be like, Tommy, you got to go potty? Got to go potty? Go
every
potty.
Time?
And then I let you out with Betsy and Fief, and then you shit and piss where they shit and
I
piss.
Got. I need to have some questions. So when...
Yeah?
When I have to lick his mouth once?
Yeah.
And lick his whole beard?
The beard, the mouth, the lips, the teeth. You just kind of give it a thorough lick, and it smells horrible.
He's been
drinking whiskey and smoking.
But it's either that, or how many times is he going to do...
Okay, so then 1 month of you peeing and pooping outside with the dogs. But it's every time I let the dogs out, you go with them. And you piss, and you shit in our yard.
It's crazy.
And then the gardener's like... Mom, I'm gonna pick this up. Wait, that's not his accent.
Wait.
I cannot pick up this shit, ma'am.
He goes,
He's not a ching chong. He goes, I cannot pick up this shit, ma'am.
And then you go.
This is people shit.
This is
not dog shit. This is human shit.
The dogs, they take a big, big shit and it's too big for me. It's like a bear shit.
Yeah, that's what I'll say. The gardener's going to be like, you got to pay me more for this, man. I cannot pick up human shit, too.
You think he'd be like,
Hey, we stay right here, homie. It's fucking morning. Fucking... We got the enemigos right there, homie. Let me represent myself, homie. It's Creeper, homie, from that G-Dub 13 gang, homie. Some Valley gang, homie. Fucking Whiner from Westside Armenian Power gang, homie. Still Puro Sureños putting it right down, here, homie. And Middle East, homie, in Syria. Still gang banging, not giving a fuck, homie.
It's big old shits out here, man. It's like these aren't dog shits. These are like people shits, man.
These are people shit. Well, here's the thing is that he kind of doesn't pick up the dog
I'm
shit.
I'm not going to shit for a month outside. That's
why? You'd rather lick all...
Yes.
You're going to throw up.
I'm
going to
vomit for sure. I'm going to vomit profusely and intensely, but it also will be all over in a day. That's why I would do that.
Yeah, but you'll remember Thief Mouth. Thief's mouth is fucking
And he'll
horrendous.
Come up to me probably for the rest of my life every day like, do you want to lick my mouth again? You want to do that again like you did that one time? But I love Thief
Mouth. Dude, he eats barf. He ate Bitsy's barf the other day.
All right. Fuck,
on the carpet.
Man. I can't go shit outside
shit.
For a month. That's crazy.
Yes, you can.
No, you can't.
Like Joey Diaz. Remember when he shit on his
that
tree in the
That was one
bag?
Time. That was an accident. This is
But here's
emergency.
The thing, bro, is I'd make it nice for you. I'd put some toilet paper out there. I put like a stool.
No.
Like a squatty potty
no,
or whatever
I'm,
for
I'm,
you.
I'm licking the dog's face once.
Oh, suit yourself.
It's a trade-off. It's a reasonable pitch that you made. But I'm definitely taking the other option.
Okay. I'm peeing and shitting outside for a month with the dogs.
Yeah.
Because I only shit once a day, not like you. You shit five times a day.
Yeah, that's the thing is I shit a lot.
Yeah.
I'm going to keep going outside. Well, I mean, if you shit that many times a day for a month, people are going to see me. So neighbors eventually are going to be like,
Hey, Tom.
What are you? Are you doing that again? The kids are out. And I'll be like, I gotta take a dump. I lost a would you rather thing. And I don't want to lick my dog's beard. What? Hi, Hitler. And then I turn around.
I kind of want to see you shit in our yard, though. I think it'd be pretty funny. We're squatting.
I've pissed
shitting.
Outside once.
In our house?
In our house, yeah.
Shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
When?
I forget. It wasn't that long ago, though.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Why?
I forget all the right. reason. I just had
I
to
don't
go.
Know anymore.
I pissed all over that wall.
Okay.
The side wall.
Are you serious? Yeah. Thank God we rent, huh? Who cares?
Yeah.
Not my problem. It's landlord's problem now.
Not my fucking problem.
Not my problem, buddy.
Oh, no.
Yeah. All right, we got
to
go. It's a long show.
Clean up the shit.
We got to go. We That's love you.
Like a people shit.
We'll see you guys in a week.
Love you, mommies.
Bye, jeans.
Honestly, and this is like, this goes for almost all the moments in the scene. It wasn't until somebody was actually there telling me, you have two in you.